nice to see all of you here. I am Ross McGreevy, supervisor of the 5th District. I represent probably one of the most diverse districts, the 5th District. My western border goes all the way out to 19th and Kirkham. My eastern border, in the sunset that is, my eastern border goes out to Gough Street or City Hall. My northern border is California. My southern border is Wallace. When I came into office as a supervisor, I've been working for the district attorney's office for 9 years. I came in and I inherited the Western Addition, the Divisadero, Haines Valley, Lower Haight area in our district that had notoriously the second highest homicide rate, violent crime rate in the city, holding steady for 20 years. I ran on the premise that I'm going to take back our streets, I'm going to reclaim our communities from violent crime, and I'm going to do it through community policing, and I'm going to do it through service programs that will be lasered into public housing. And you know what? My district has the highest drop in violent crime citywide, holding 3 years. If you've ever been to Divisadero recently, it's my comeback kid story between Haight and Gary. And what's special about that? It's not gentrification. We've been able to retain the mom and pop populism on Divisadero. On the Fillmore Corridor, south of Post and Gary, getting over the invisible Berlin Wall between Gary that separates Japantown from the African-American community of the Western Addition. We've also been able to help reinvest in the economic vitality of the Fillmore community as well, too. Same with Lower Haight. What this race is about for sheriff is not who can out-cop each other. I know I have two opponents who have a seasoned track record in law enforcement. Good for them. But I want to remind you that Sheriff Mike Hennessy, he was never a cop. When he was elected, he was an ACLU attorney. And he was probably the sheriff, first sheriff in the United States to break ground, to innovate the kind of smart on crime and the kind of reentry rehabilitative programs that no other sheriff in the state of California has, or even in the United States. Sheriff Mike Hennessy, which I am honored to have his endorsement, and he's only endorsing me, as he has said, is looking for somebody who's independent. It's not that I also have law enforcement experience, 10 years. I was also in the military, honorable discharge from the U.S. Navy. I'm not going to sit here and sort of boast about my law enforcement resume. What I want to talk about is exactly what the sheriff does. What the sheriff does is the sheriff sets policy for the jails and for reentry programs, implementation of policy for management of jails, enforcement of discipline, and management of a peace officer and a civilian staff force. You should know that the sheriff's department is not under the police commission. There is no OCC for the sheriff's department. There is no Office of Citizen Complaints. The person who administers disciplinary regulations is the sheriff himself. And let me tell you, you have somebody who's the former president of the police union, who fought against consent decree and police reform and accountability, then I would not believe they were necessarily going to maintain that level of independence over law enforcement. And you have somebody from the deputy sheriff's department who's also running to have been hired by Mike Hennessy. I would also like to stress the fact that this is not just about protecting deputy sheriff. What this is about is recognizing the fact that Sheriff Mike Hennessy's probably done more for black and brown people than any other politician in San Francisco in recent history. Why? Because the majority of the clientele in the county jail, in the jail system, are the same people who come back to communities like the Ten Point, the Western Addition, Bayview, Sunnydale, Visitation Valley, Soma, Ingleside, and the other communities that happen to be the most pronounced in distress for public safety, and also happen to be the same communities that are economically distressed. I have to tell you, as a supervisor, we completely bang our heads against the wall about dealing with, I think, the false imagery of San Francisco being so progressive and so forward-thinking by people who accuse us of being progressive, knowing very well of the pockets of poverty that we have through a chic city like San Francisco, and not helping connect the dots that what happens inside the jail system very well affects what happens outside the jail system. And those dots need to be inextricably entwined. As sheriff of San Francisco, I will marry the power of redemption on one end by having effective reentry programs and put it together with the other booking of being smart on crime. I will improve public safety citywide, just like I was able to prove in my own district. And I have exceeded my jurisdiction as a supervisor. You might remember that I delivered the first veto override to Mayor Newsom when he wouldn't give me foot patrols for the Western Addition. And when Mayor Newsom wouldn't do that, I legislated the mandate for community policing and foot patrols. And you know what? The byproduct, the consequences of it, was clear and the correlation vivid. We were able to bring down crime rates, build trust where a community has trust that has been notoriously thin between police, government, and them, and we've been able to show a level of collaboration that hadn't existed before. We have to recognize that if we want to improve public safety, it also means tackling recidivism rates. And this...
Sorry, I was listening to you.
Was I that captivating?
What?
I need to be a time, but
give about 10 more seconds in the closing.
No, I just want to say, know this. I'm the longest serving member of the Board of Supervisors Budget Committee. We put the $500 million almost to the police department. We front-load all this money to public safety. For every four people that the police department arrests and the DA prosecutes, almost three are repeat offenders within 3 years. Now, when you look at the money we put for rehabilitation, it is a short shrift. Our priorities are mixed up. And I want to say that inside the jails and outside, we will build on effective reentry, we'll turn people's lives around, and we'll improve public safety throughout San Francisco. Thank you very much.